from my old Kentucky home.
So everything is starting to sprout and come up on the homestead here. There are some trouble spots I need to replant. Not many, but some. Some beet areas and some carrot areas that I need to redo. Beans are coming up. Need to kind of thicken them up a little bit on the ones that didn't come up. Some rows look better than others. But for the most part, everything seems to be coming up pretty well. Like I was saying, Swiss chard has been coming up all over the place. And some tomatoes as well. As a matter of fact, I had a cabbage that died, and I took some of that Swiss chard and I put it right here. It's weird how one cabbage right here will do well and one will do okay, and then in the middle they'll just die. But so goes planting. Well, it's got me to thinking that, you know, I get all these volunteers, these vegetables that come up each year from nothing. I mean, the plants are all pulled up and burned and chopped down, and still I get seedlings from plants that were planted in a certain area, like right here. This area is where those heirloom tomatoes were. These heirloom tomatoes, getting toward the end of their life. And look at here. I got tomatoes coming up. And I'm going to let them come on up. I might even cage them off, along with these right near the purple hull peas. See what happens. But isn't that easy? I didn't do anything. As a matter of fact, I gave it every opportunity for those not to come up. I tilled the soil twice. That's not so good. I made these rows, piled it up, buried the seed for the most part, and still they found their way to the surface. It's amazing. It's amazing. And so I've been doing some research on permaculture and other types of gardening, homesteading, that may be more sustainable rather than this chore each year of tilling and turning and replanting and weeding. There's got to be an easier way. And so I've been doing a lot of research on permaculture, things that are sustainable to a certain point to where I just have to maintain it, just provide some maintenance rather than so much manipulation, if you know what I'm saying. It's Thursday afternoon, and we're supposed to get a good rain tomorrow. It's supposed to rain, 100% chance. Looking at the sky, it looks pretty clear. But a high today of only like 58 or 59. I mean, it's the 24th of May, and we didn't even get to the 60s today. So that really puts a hamper on all the growth. If you remember, I planted cucumbers here, and this cardboard is just curling up too much. I'm afraid it's just not going to work. I think I'm going to use some of my black plastic, and I'm going to cover up an area here for them to grow and to vine out on. I think that would be the best thing to do. We'll change that this weekend. Now, I saved some crookneck squash gourds from last year, and I'm going to see. There's seeds in these things, and how viable are these seeds? They've been out all winter, protected in these hard containers. You know, organic containers. I might crack them open and plant a few seeds just to see if they sprout. I mean, if you look at my rhubarb, it comes up every year. I don't do anything. I just let it do its thing, and still it comes up. It's the same way with his herb bed. Things just come back year after year after year, and I don't really do much. I just plant it and it comes back. Is there a way to do that with like tomatoes or squash, zucchini, corn? Is there a way to do that? That's what I'm going to figure out.
To call my own. Little birdie, come and sing to me your song.
It's the 25th of May. We had a good rain today. like I suspected. I was glad to get the yard mowed yesterday, or the grass harvested rather. And actually I didn't harvest, I just mulched it back down into the ground. And also the weeds chopped over. A lot of those little green things you see between the rows are dead and drying up weeds. They'll do their job and go back into the soil sometime soon. Really, you can see here over in the zucchini bed that we got some good germination going, some better than others. If you can see here, a little seed popped its head out. It probably got planted too deeply, and so I'll probably replant another one there. I like to have about two plants per hole, if you know what I'm saying, and pretty much I have that in the zucchini bed. Purple hull peas are coming up, but sporadically. I think the same thing happened last year with the purple hull peas, where I've got part that germinated and the other part just didn't do well. And so I'll reinforce that. I've got plenty of seed left, and so I'll reinforce that. It looks like the duckweed's doing pretty good. We get some growth, starting to clump together, starting to center out a little bit. Got a good rain, like I said earlier, and I think that refreshed the water quite a bit. If when we don't get any good duckweed growth, we at least have some good compost tea, it appears, as dark as it can get. It looks as if the pump system I set up, where I tried to keep it out of the water, keep it out of the rain, because it is connected to electricity, looks like it worked pretty well. Nothing's wet on the inside of that container, so it looks like it held up good from that rain. We had a pretty good rain, as a matter of fact, so looks like it's doing its job. It's midday Saturday, and it's been raining all day. I mean, literally all day. It rained yesterday evening, and it rained all day today so far. The upside is we won't be having to water today or tomorrow, so that's pretty good. One of the biggest problems we're having is the temperature. I'm just not getting the germination that I'm supposed to be getting. I'm getting real good growth on potatoes, spinach, cabbage, but as far as the other vegetables that require some warmth, I'm just not doing very well. My purple hull peas, about 50%, green beans, about 50%. Everything's just kind of hanging around. We've only been getting to a high of the low 60s and upper 50s. And here it is, you know, end of May, and we're shooting at the first week of June coming up. And so you can imagine the problems that we're having as far as that's concerned. Mushy food. I think they kind of like mushy food, to be honest with you. Now, if you remember, they were having some weak eggs, and so we went ahead and got some calcium. And we feed that to them as well as their crushed eggshells, and they tend to do pretty well. Nice. Nice. Gotta love that. Okay, what I have here is a homemade black soldier fly harvest bucket. And if you've not seen one of these before, there's some plans on the internet that you can find. And I'm going to put a link to that guy's website in the show notes and also to his YouTube videos. It's fantastic. I'm going to give credit where credit's due. This is not my my invention. I just copied his plans and went with it. This is my first one that I've built, and so I was pretty impressed with his, and so I decided to build me one. I went ahead and placed it near my compost bin here where we put our kitchen scraps, and I'm going to put some scraps into this as well to try to attract some black soldier flies. Let me give you a look on the inside. Okay, so what we have here is an area, a filter. This is what they use for air conditioners and heater vents to keep the dust out. So hopefully they won't be able to chew through that. I put it in there pretty snug so we wouldn't get any that would crawl down and try to bury themselves down below that. There's some other filter material there as well, and I'll go over that after a while. This tube is the tube that they're going to crawl up. And so in theory, they would go ahead and start eating, the larva will start eating away at the debris, and then they will crawl around and eventually make it up to here, right here, and then crawl up this tube, and then of course fall down into this container right here where I'll catch them and then feed them to the chickens. So it's pretty cool. I'm gonna go ahead and fill it full of some compost. Okay, so once we get that full like that, not too full, a few inches, and that's gonna compost down, I'm sure. We're gonna go ahead and lock it up and get it ready for some visitors. I don't know when they'll come. It's still been pretty cool. It's only getting to the highs of the low 60s. I think tomorrow, on Monday, Memorial Day, we're going to be up into the 70s, and through the rest of the week we'll be in the 70s. So that'll be pretty nice. Maybe the garden will start perking back up and we'll start getting some more growth. But as far as this, I suspect that it'll have to get a little warmer before the black flies come. Now here in southwest Idaho, I don't know if we get too many flies. I have seen them. Last year I got a few in my worm bin. And I was very encouraged by that. So hopefully we'll be able to get some black flies and go from there. Now I'm going to show you a watering system I learned from a gentleman on YouTube. It's the Bayou Gardener. Really appreciate all his videos. He puts out some good information. I'll put a link in the show notes for this particular how-to. You take 5-foot section of PVC, inch and a half PVC. They sell it in 10-foot sections, so just cut one in half. Get you a cap and just shove her in just like that. You don't have to glue it or anything like that, just shove it right in. And we're going to take it and we're going to drill a small hole at an angle right above that cap. Let me show you. I see I put a slight angle on that when I went in. I kind of went in up at an angle. Now, unfortunately, it's about to rain. As a matter of fact, it's already starting to sprinkle. So in showing this as a demonstration, that's going to take another day. But let me just give you the basic idea. You put water in at the top, it fills up the tube, and through the small hole at the bottom, it slowly releases the water down to the plant near the actual roots, and you don't have the problem with loss of nutrition or leaching of your fertilizers, if you put any fertilizers in your soil. Not to mention the actual natural fertilizer that's found in compost and other kind of natural ingredients. So you don't lose all that with this slow drip system. So what I'll do is I'll come back on another day where we don't have any risk of rain, and we'll show you how this thing works. But this gives you the idea. If you look at the Bayou Gardener's video, then you'll get a real good idea about how these things work. I'm going to try it on these four plants and see how it works. And this is kind of my first year to do this, and we'll just see how it goes.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'd rather be in some dark hole, where the sun don't ever shine, than to see you with another when you promised to be mine. Little birdie, come and sing to me your song. I got a short time to stay here and a long time to be gone, and a long time to be gone.
I made this.